nice and easy.
Is that it then? Get that party real soon.
Yeah, give me some surge.
Yeah,
I guess so.
She literally bought 15 rolls of toilet paper. What? As if this whole Y2K thing happens, toilet paper is going to save her life.
Like, it's going to be over. There's no more toilet paper.
It's crazy.
Well, you know, once it rolls over, everything's going to roll back.
We're going to be at zero.
Yeah, we're going to be at zero. Robots.
It's going to be nuts.
So somewhere like Radiohead, yours is one of our, it's not ever just about hip-hop.
I like the Rolling Stones as much as I like Beach Boys.
Right
there.
Yeah, it's going to be a great concert for you. I'm excited about it.
So I told her Noise Cry would have happened in the beginning.
Hey guys, shoot. I get your attention real quick. Sorry to interrupt. But Corey and I have been working on this documentary. I'm taking a film class right now. And, I mean, we've been working on it for a little bit, and I'd love for you guys to actually take a look, give me some opinions, see maybe what we could do better. But just, I'd love you to take a look and watch a little bit. So I'm just going to, plug this in real quick. Corey usually works the camera. Hi, my name is Paul Hudson, and here we find ourselves standing in front of Townley Court apartment buildings in Columbus, Georgia. This beautiful building is a historic landmark in this wonderful neighborhood. What was built in the late 1920s, now an apartment building, used to be one of the finest hotels in the city. However, this isn't a documentary about a hotel. It's about the man who owned it. George Joyner inherited the hotel at a young age after the untimely death of his father. If youth and inexperience were hurdles, George had no trouble clearing them. The hotel continued to maintain its reputation of excellence. However, as this is not just a documentary about a hotel, it is also not just a documentary about a man. It is about what happened to him. On New Year's Eve at the strike of midnight, he disappeared from this elevator, or so the story goes. In any case, it was the last place that he was ever seen alive. Some say he simply skipped town and never returned. But ever since that night, people say they see the ghost of young George Joyner wandering the halls. Next to the old piano, sounds from the boiler room. Always, he is said, to look sad, lost. Are they just stories? Or is this something supernatural? We may never know what truly happened. Like all the best mysteries, the answer is out of reach, somewhere back there, frozen in time.
I mean, it's cool, man. Like, the camera shots are really good, and I feel like the
facts and stuff are there, and I think that's great, and I think the camera angles in the script, it's wonderful, but I feel like you're not really, like, showing us the story. Like, we're getting it told and not showed, and I think it'd be better if you could actually, like, show what really happened and what really went on.
Who's calling at this hour of the night?
Oh, it's Ronnie. He said the furnace is out at the hotel. I'll go down and give him a hand.
I thought you said when we moved to Georgia it wasn't going to be cold anymore.
It gets cold at night.
That's why you shouldn't abandon us.
I'll be back before midnight.
Please hurry.
Baby?
Baby? Is he a baby?
Good, you?
I'm good. How can I help you?
Well, working on the furnace tonight. I was wondering if it's working up here.
I'm not sure. Let me go check. I'll be right back.
All right, thanks.
Qu'est-ce que tu fais ici?
It appears as though the furnace is working. Can we convince you to join us? We're about to do the New Year's countdown.
No, thank you. My wife just had a baby. I need to get home.
Oh, congratulations.
Thank you.
Good boy.
All set. You ready to go?
Let's do this. Showtime.
All right, there you go. Channel one?
Channel one. See you guys.
Loud and clear.
Alpha 1, over. Alpha 2 acknowledges, Rob.
Alright, Corey, we're almost ready. Get ready, I'll let you know.
The apartment's right above me. I'm going to let you know and send you down, okay?
Roger, I'll be ready. Over. Roger. Roger. Roger, over.
11, 10!
Go, go, it's time, go.
Roger.
Happy New Year!
Happy New
Year.
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 Alright, let's see if he's alive. Corey, you dead, buddy?
Oh. What?
He's not in here. Corey. Cora?
Oh. All right. Nice to well, be.
Maybe he got off upstairs.
Okay, I'll go check upstairs.
All right. I'll check down here. Did you find
him? No, he's on the
fence. All right, we need to check the camera.
Okay.
Look. It's gone.
Very funny. Funny guys. Comedians. Lucky I don't give you a wet willy.
Check this floor. If you guys could check that side and then upstairs, we'll meet back here in 5 minutes.
Okay.
Okay. Look, I know this sounds crazy, and I don't believe it, but what if it's like in the documentary? What if Corey's gone? What if we can't find him again? What if he's stuck in time? What would that be like? Corey, and where is he? What's he doing? Is he okay?
Well, you started out with simple songs and stories. Didn't want to give me too much worry in your warning. I knew there was too much glory in that morning. I turned around and you were gone. Started out with simple songs and stories. I knew there was too much glory. Thank you. started out with simple songs and stories. Didn't wanna give me too much worry in your morning. I knew there's too much glory in the morning. I turned around.